Hello everybody, welcome back. This is Orange Galen, and today we're watching more Fairy Tail, the final series, episodes 21 and 22. So, a little bit of information and real life stuff. I'm actually pre-recording this. This is Wednesday the 11th, and the reason I'm doing this is because I got when this comes out, this previous week's schedule, and I don't have a day off until Friday. For me this week, the Wednesday the 11th until this past Friday, I don't have a day off, but I have a couple half days, strangely enough. So I'm going to be recording this during that. So, oh well. It's a weird schedule, but it's just before Christmas. So I guess they need help. I don't know. It's weird. My schedule is weird. There's a day where I have to get up and go to work at 5 in the morning, which is gonna suck. Anyway, so last time, what happened last time? Oh yeah, Brandish kind of is reconciled with Lucy a little bit now. Aquarius came back briefly, found out that Lucy needs to get her keys from somewhere in the world. So it's like the ultimate scavenger hunt. Just one thing in the entire world. But of course, fairy tale luck, so they're gonna find it soon, maybe. And also found out something a little interesting, because apparently the Eclipse Gate needs 2 celestial spirit or celestial wizards to open it up. So that's how the Dragon Slayers came in, because there was Anahart Philia that opened it in 400 years ago, and then it was Layla that opened it in 777, and because she didn't have Aquarius, she needed to use her own life force to open it up. And oh yeah, she died that same day, July 7th, 777, so, or like the night before. In any case, that begs the question, because I don't know if somebody answered it in the questions or like in the comments last time. Once again, I'm pre-recording this, or if I just completely missed it, but because during like the whole Grand Magic Games, the dragons came through. We had Hisui that opened up the gate on 791, right? If I'm getting my fairy tale years correct. She opened it then. But who is the celestial wizard on the other side? Or in that case, did they find a way to tune it so that they could open it with only the one? And it was just like an open portal or something like that into the past or something. I don't know. It's the continuity sort of thing is not there for me, at least. So tell me in the comments if I missed something, or if you agree with me or disagree, or if there's some other explanation. There we go. So Loxus is fighting Wall now, and Urza and Kagura are going to face the guy that's on the boat. And it's the Sky's sisters, Shelia and Wendy, facing off against Dimaria, is her name, I believe? The yellow-haired girl, or the blonde, I guess you would say. Yeah, don't have anything else. Let's start. I also have some M&Ms I'm going to be snacking on, so.
Survival confirmed. Activating pursuit system. Generating missiles. Fire!
Oh yeah, Loxus is still suffering from the Bane particles.
Generating high voltage cannon! Oh no! Electrical attacks only feed his magic power! But they don't affect me at all!
I'm claiming this little one for myself.
Ah! Wendy, it's you! Sorry I got here late, but the Sky Sisters are back in action!
That brat kicked me in the face.
Bum 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum. Me and you. Bad times changed again. Yeah, it's all torn up back there.
All those Bane particles wreaking havoc on you have finally caught up, leaving you completely incapacitated. No wonder you're having trouble breathing. Even if you were at your prime, your lightning wouldn't affect me. We're at checkmate right now, so you'd better make your peace.
Not yet. No, damn it!
I'm going to end it all for you. You should be grateful. This humiliation and agony you're going through will be over in an instant. As will your life.
In a silent time.
Commence charging prohibited ether nano-based armament. Magic fusion generator at critical output. Kill system.
What?
Online.
Was that Ethereon?
Activating Ethereon.
I came back for one reason, and that was to protect Fairy Tail. A guild that stood the test of time. For 100 years!
Rune Circle?
Wait, what does he think he's doing? But why would he create something like this in the middle of our fight?
Learn something a little from Freed.
Freed taught me this one himself. All I gotta do is stay inside the circle.
What a pointless waste of energy! Have you already forgotten that enchantments are ineffective against me? Bane Particle Canceller!
Thanks, Freed. I know there aren't many wizards out there who can break through your enchantments like that. So I'm lucky this bastard found me. Because he's doing it by neutralizing Bane Particles.
What?
Which happens to be exactly what the Doctor ordered.
What the hell?
What just happened?
I'm not usually the kind of guy who'd wipe somebody out right after they saved my life. But I gotta get payback for what you did to my friends!
Your lightning won't hurt me at all! And that means you're completely powerless, is G!
Cause their lives are worth something! A hell of a lot more than mine!
It's useless!
What?
Dark Red Lightning! What is this?
Is that like devil slaying?
You never met Yuri. Did you know he was Makarov's father? So that means he's your great-grandfather.
I'm actually related to one of the guys who started Fairy Tail.
Oh, is this during the OVA?
It makes me wonder why the old man never once mentioned it to me.
You remind me of Yuri quite a bit, to be honest.
Oh yeah? What was he like?
He was always smiling, and an inspiration to everyone he met.
That doesn't sound like me.
But above all, he cared. His true friends were precious to him.
Well, from now on, my dream is to always protect you, no matter the cost. To trust you and put all my faith in you.
That really doesn't sound like me. I practically tore the guild apart a few years ago. Turned everyone against each other. People got hurt. Blows my mind they let me back in.
But you didn't let those mistakes hold you back forever. In that way, you're exactly like him. Ha!
Megaton Red Lightning!
What?
Lightning that goes beyond lightning. And red is the blood in my veins.
You're a demon of the Book of Xerath. You'll die too.
There's gotta be another way. And I swear I'm not giving up until we find it.
Warren, I need a situation report from you, please.
No movement from Zaref's division out to the west. Seems to be a stalemate up north. But I'm optimistic that the tables will start to turn once Gajiel and his crew finally get there.
What about the east? Any word from the four emperors of Ishgar?
We haven't gotten any kind of status report from them. But I can see here that one of the 12 vanished, and the other two are currently heading this way.
They got past those guys.
We know if Jura's okay?
How about Urza? Any news from her group?
One of the 12 there vanished too.
Huh.
Maybe that means somebody took them down.
If that's the case, we might actually pull this off.
Yeah, and don't forget, we've already taken one of them prisoner.
That would mean there's only 8 of them to go. We got this.
No. There are still forces coming from the east where we have no defense in place. And Zaref won't hold his position in the west forever. We could really use your tactical prowess right now, First Master. What's wrong?
I just need some more time. What can I do to beat Zaref? Think, Mavis.
Come on! Right!
Now, water! Slicer!
Juvia, they're behind you!
No!
Water body. Or not. Who's that? Oh! Verity.
Good to see you again.
Melzi!
Yeah.
Hey! What are you doing here?
Crime Sorcier is joining the battle.
Did she grow a size?
She's adorable.
Or is it just clothes?
Looks like the port's up ahead. Wait, I see somebody.
Alright, oh, some more lackeys.
We're the 4 Crest Knights of the Nineheart Division.
You've no chance of getting past us.
Don't stop. I got it. Push through!
I thought you were supposed to be injured.
A little pain wouldn't stop you, would it?
We're the 4 Crest Knights because there's 4 of us!
Big mistake!
Hey, Jalal. Oh yeah, Kagra is still...
Sorry I wasn't here sooner.
You should hide your face.
No, I'm done running and hiding. I made the decision it was
It's like,
time
plus, at this point, it doesn't
Zaref
really matter.
For all.
Jalal.
Oh yeah, that freaking...
I don't care if you're kids, I show mercy to no one. The truth is, I could kill you in the blink of an eye.
Get ready, girls.
A split second would last an eternity.
Okay. She has some sort of time magic?
It's like I'm the only person in the world right now.
Oh, great.
All of it laid out before me.
Another time mage.
Everyone's had the thought at least once in their lives. I wish there was some way I could stop time. But I can actually make that happen with my Aj seal. Understand? I wouldn't trade this power for anything in the world. I can do whatever I please right now. Believe me, it's a rush. Should I rip your clothes to shreds and embarrass you too? No, I think I've done enough playing around. I could easily kill you all and be done with it. But that just sounds so boring to me. Okay, so when time starts moving again, one of you will be lying dead on the ground. Yep, that definitely works for me. So now, I gotta figure out which one. Oh, who am I kidding? It has to be this little face kicker here. Sweet dreams, child. It's the end of the line.
What?
Are you ready? Yeah, you bet.
How? This is my world. How can they move?
Leading Sky Arrow! Trailing Sky Arrow! I swear I just heard somebody's voice inside my head. So did I.
The universe has been distorted. This world we're in now is a rift in time itself.
How? Also, nice ass shot.
You think you're the only one who inhabits it? You're sorely mistaken.
How? Wasn't she, like, freaking old?
This is my domain as well.
Altier? How?
It serves as a temporal prison of sorts. And I've come on behalf of Crime Sorcière to punish you for your transgressions.
I know you! You're Altier!
Are you the one who unlocked my flow of time?
Well, how could I be when time is still stopped?
It stopped?
This space between is my home now. In fact,
her home now?
I can only truly exist inside this ephemeral territory. By interrupting the normal flow of the cosmos, you unwittingly placed yourself within this peculiar domain in which I dwell. Consider this your welcome.
This is supposed to be my world. How dare you defile it?
If she was the only one who could move freely while time was standing still for all of us, we'd have been killed in the blink of an eye, like she said. Hold on. So when that happened before, time was stopped? I don't understand. What's going on here?
Her magic has the power to stop time completely. However, since I removed myself from the normal order of things, I can exist where life has ceased following that order. And luckily for you, I realized that I was able to allow you to move in here with us.
There were rumors you vanished soon after the Eclipse Gate was closed.
This whole thing seems like an ass pull, but...
Being in the rift of time like this, it's not so bad.
Get out now!
But I have no true corporeal form, which means I'm not able to fight alongside you.
Get
no corporeal form?
A projection?
Hurry! You can only move while I hold time in place, and I can't do it much longer!
Got it! Here we go!
This world belongs to me alone, and I won't let anyone interfere with it!
Sky Dragon Wing Attack! Sky God Boreas!
Guess I need to show you why I control time, as well as the true power that the Spriggan 12 can wield.
When you show you, hang on!
What is she doing? Her power's incredible.
You know, for having no corporeal form, you sure are affected by stuff like that.
My ultimate spell. Take over, God Soul.
The strength of a god?
This can't be happening.
Oh boy. Well, Gunslayer. It's time for...
What's the matter, Lucy? Did you have a nightmare?
More like a bad feeling. I don't think I can rest while everyone else is fighting.
Well, what was it? Something about Natsu?
I don't really know exactly.
Natsu is gonna be fine.
Hearken to my voice. A god is among you now. Kronos, god of time.
Is everybody still okay?
I could have never anticipated this. The power of the god of time. How did she obtain something?
She's cracking.
So terrifying?
I am a god of the ancient Mildians. Dimaria was born from their lineage. Together we have become one singular force.
Okay.
So you say you're a god, huh? Well, I think you're gonna be sorry you decided to start a fight with a god slayer.
No. Uh-oh. No.
Wendy!
No, no, no. She's frozen in time.
She killed her. Kyla! Kyla! No.
I mean, you're both healing mages, so maybe?
Kyla! Please don't leave me!
You have desecrated my realm. For your trespass, death is the only atonement.
Kyla! No!
She's still alive. For now.
Yeah, she's so frozen.
She's injured, but I ejected her from this place we're in. In other words, she's back where time has stopped.
She was only trying to help me. And now she's stuck.
I was almost too late. Once time starts crumbling again, she'll be in real danger. That means you'll have to win this fight. And at the moment time moves forward, cast a full power healing spell to save her.
Ultir, you're cracking! What's happening?
My hold on this rift is beginning to wane. I can only keep you here a little longer.
Come on, let's do it! Yeah!
These girls, they don't have a chance in this battle. She has a god's power behind her. That look in their eyes. They have no fear. Whatever happens, they'll fight till the end. To win, you'll need to use the power of the future.
What do you mean?
Your potential. Meaning, the power that you will gain in the future, you'll need to use it all now.
Second origin?
That's the only hope you'll have of winning here. However, once you've used this spell, that's it. You'll lose your magical ability forever.
Oh, that's bull.
Tell me, will you pay that price? The cost of the third origin.
So many ass pulls in this episode. I don't even really know how to begin with that. So Ultir only exists in like pockets of time now. The explanation was a little unclear on that. At some point, I'm going to look at the wiki. I guess in between me recording this and then the next episode, I'll look it up in the wiki to better understand it. But that was a little weird. And then now, friggin' Dimaria has takeover God Soul. Apparently, her bloodline was from the ancient something or other gods. And there's something called a third origin. Which, it's like, no, I like Wendy too much for her to not use magic anymore. Alright, that was episode 21. Let's move on to episode 22. Alright, so I pulled up the wiki, and, two things that I got the answer to the red lightning dragon mode, apparently, is something that Loxus can do now. This is a red lightning dragon. Once again, another power-up sort of thing. But then with the Ultir thing, Ultir apparently is only a concept in that time where she can only exist in the time rift created by Dimaria. Once again, like I keep saying, it's a little bit of like an A-pole, but whatever. At some point, you just kind of have to roll with it. with just kind of the ridiculousness. It's also just stuff like this. I mean, yeah, it's sort of okay, but then also it's just the kind of like there's no build up, and they just like, oh, here's something I could do. Here's third origin now. Second origin was a little better explained, at least. So that makes more sense than third origin. So third origin apparently is like this, everything at once, but then you can't use magic ever again afterwards. So it just doesn't, because stuff like that, I just don't like things that are just like, oh, this is now here now, and everybody just immediately accepts it or is like a master at it. Because with Loxus, we haven't seen him use that before or like know anything about it, so all of a sudden it's just there. And then you have I also looked at the article and it said that the magic rune circle that Loxus used was designed so that it would neutralize Bane particles, but only if somebody you activated my trap card. If only somebody would it would neutralize all particles, but that would also include the Bane particles. So that's the ultimate, you have to activate my trap card. But where was I? Yeah, it's just, I don't like stuff that's just all of a sudden just kind of there without any sort of explanation, you know? Maybe it's just me. I don't know. Maybe I'm just being a little too nitpicky. Or maybe not nitpicky enough. Who knows? All right, so this is going to be episode 22.
What is she doing?
My ultimate spell. Take over God's soul.
The strength of a god?
Me and you. Bad times changed again. I was just thinking in between this and the
unlock a
intro
source of magic known as the third origin. This technique will allow you to access
like,
all the power you have.
Considering that
to gain throughout
I've
your life.
Complained about Anselm before, power, like how he's just kind
forever.
Of like the Greek
You'll
gods.
Never be able to use magic again.
We haven't seen a lot of
the ether
benevolent gods in fairy tale.
Extinguished. It cannot be regenerated. I know it's a difficult decision to make. However, to stand any chance of beating her, this is the option you have.
If that's what it takes, okay.
I'd
no hesitation.
We both have strong reactions to this, but there is a caveat. I can only do this for one of you. The other must keep her magic to heal Carla.
Make sure that she's okay. That's your job. I know, which is exactly why I have to fight for her now. Let me... I think it's why you need to keep your magic, so you can heal her and fight together another day. If you do this, you'll never be able to use magic ever again!
Same for you.
Yeah, and it's the same for you, you know? I came out here today because I wanted to help you. If you lost your magic, I would never forgive myself! I'm ready to make the sacrifice, Altair!
And you're sure this is what you truly want?
If this is what it takes to save my friends, then I'll do it! Don't throw it away for me!
What are you quarreling about?
She's coming! Come on, Altair, I'm ready!
All right, then. Here goes!
I'll take care of her!
Natsu revived!
Sky Dragon Talon!
Hearken to my voice. I am a god who has control over time itself. And time remembers all the pain that's been inflicted on your body over the years.
What?
Odd scratch!
What's happening? I've never felt pain like this! Please don't do this! You've gotta stop before it's too late! But if this is what it takes to save my friends, so be it!
You've made a grave mistake. Do you not understand the folly of a mortal trying to touch a god?
What's going on? How can I already?
Has my third origin not been fully released yet?
Now, Pierce, to the very end of time.
I'm so weak, but I gotta move!
What?
Shelia?
I made it. Just in time.
I'll be handling this one, Wendy. There's no way I'm gonna lose.
Oh, she was the one that got... What?
Sorry. But we needed you to buy us a little more time while she used the third origin spell on me. Is that true?
Shelia and I both agreed that this was for the best.
It was her idea? You and I both know Fairy Tail's battle won't be over after this, which means Wendy is gonna need all the power she can get in the future.
Damn it, Shelia. No win scenario in this.
Fighting a god, so we have a better chance at winning if you make me stronger. All I want is for everyone to survive this, so please use the third origin on me. No. This will be my final performance, and I've never felt better, because I'm happy to fight for my friends.
Useless! How dare you defy a god!
The only thing I'm defying is evil! But the fact that you're a god is actually good for me! Because my power works best against people like you! It's God Slayer magic!
So that power is real? I thought she was just bluffing! She's losing grasp over her god soul!
Curse you! But how?
I hit her with everything I have! An enchantment?
That's new.
I screwed up a lot of stuff in my life. But there's one thing that I've always been good at. Magic. Thanks to magic, I've met so many wonderful people and gone on tons of adventures. I love it so much, and I know I always will. Even though that will never change, I'll have to go back to an ordinary world where I'm just a regular person. This will be the last spell I'll ever use! What's really important in this life? Gathering clouds of heaven!
My world is crumbling around me.
Perfectly fine living a normal life. Cause love is a whole lot better than magic.
Those girls, they're so strong. If only I could have experienced a love that powerful when I was their tender age.
I mean, I wish I was a little bit more surprised at that, because, like, I got the emotional thing, but it just didn't hit that break point where it was truly, like, hit me.
Another Spriggan 12's off the radar! That's one more down!
Whoa! That means almost half have been taken out!
That's awesome! We got this, guys!
The eternal optimism of the young.
Mavis.
What's wrong? Is there a problem, First Master?
The East. The two remaining Spriggan 12 members aren't moving.
Have they stopped their advance?
I have a strange feeling about this.
Guess who?
Well, it's a nice guild you got here.
Be a shame if someone messed it up.
With the fragrance of alcohol. I'd heard this was an old guild, but it seems you've done a spot of remodeling.
Hey, who are you?
I'm one of the distinguished members of the Alvarez Empire Spriggan 12. Name's Jacob Lesio, if you're curious.
But how? My radar says...
It was a good idea to track us like that. But you see, we have this crafty old wizard named August in all ranks.
All right.
He realized that our movements were being watched, so he had to go and fix that now, didn't he?
You're seriously gonna take us on all by yourself?
It's what I prefer. Makes more sense for me. No soldiers and nobody else getting in my way. Now, don't get me wrong. I do rather like traveling with August, the guy I mentioned earlier, because he can really hold his own.
I mean,
but I was feeling
good conversationalist.
So I came ahead of him. Does your country honor respect for the HD? Judging from your silence, that's a no. But back in Alakadashia, that day is today. A time when we can let our elders know that we cherish them and everything they've done for us. That's why I decided I'd come here first to get rid of you fairies. And give old man August the break that he so deserves. Pour me a drink. Make sure it's a strong one.
We're not giving a monster like you make a it drop poisoned. Of alcohol.
Oh, well, that's a real shame, isn't it? I was going to honor you too, old man. I thought that sharing in the very last drink of your life might mean something.
And this would be my last one?
You should know I'm an assassin by trade. Although I find it unbecoming to brag, my targets never meet me twice.
I've never heard of an assassin who works out in the open like this.
Perhaps
I mean, there is Raven Trinity. Or Trinity Raven.
Your typical assassin spends hours looking around.
What frickin' metallic guy?
For the moment to strike, but that's not the way I do things. Care to guess why? Because I don't need to hide. The bodies and witnesses all disappear. That simple. No one left to tell the tale. What the hell is happening?
The fuck?
This can't be.
Makarov! Makau! Kana! Where did everyone go?
One more lift. Seems we've got a ghost on our hands.
Uh-oh.
That's strange. Nobody outside of Fairy Tale should be able to see or hear me.
There you are.
I'm just a spirit. How is he able to hurt me?
Hey, are you just refusing to talk to me, or what? I think I know who you are. You're who the Emperor was talking about, the one he called Fairy Heart. My guess is your body is somewhere around here. Talk! Tell me where and I'll bring back your friends. I made them vanish by putting them in a place that's near death but not quite all the way there. But if I decide to leave them that way, they'll be dead before long. So I want you to tell me what to do with them.
If I choose my friends, that means the world could be doomed. But I have no reason to trust that this guy will bring them back. I don't know what to do.
Tell me.
Yeah!
Hey, are you okay? Did he hurt you? Lucy, you're still here.
And so is Happy.
Aye, sir. But, where is everyone?
He made them disappear and he's going to kill them.
That must have been the spatial magic from before.
You'd better let our friends go now!
Star dress change! Time for Leo style!
but bollocks. I can't sell in the entire guild hall, so how'd I miss them?
What is that?
Ferozium?
Sounds like something crazy is going on in there.
You think we should go and check it out, or...
Again, Lucy loses her clothes.
It seems like I got here right in the nick of time, Miss Lucy.
What are you doing here?
Well, you see, I detected a major spatial distortion just now. But hold on, why am I naked? You might ask embarrassedly. Like it or not, it's simply part of this defensive spell.
Right, that's what happened with Wendy before.
You might uncomfortably exclaim.
Hey, not you. That kind of tickles.
Miss Lucy, please try to remember that you are a proper lady.
Well, once again, I owe you one.
I won't be able to use this defensive spell for a while, so I ask that you exercise caution.
Hey, Lucy, check it out.
Oh, not too.
Fire dragon!
Why did you make me look?
God damn it, Happy. You freaking troll.
Was that the first master?
Let's go!
The stars were looking out for us.
Aye, they were!
Well, if you'd vanished with the rest, you would have avoided what's about to happen. Listen up, ghost. I'm changing the terms of the deal. I think it'd be more fun to tear this bird into pieces until you've made up your mind. When the feeling strikes you, I suggest you'd surrender. Otherwise, she might just be a pretty blonde head.
Lucy! Get out of the way!
Yeah, not so. Ooh.
Even if she was just a head, she'd still be our friend Lucy. But since you threatened her like that, I'm gonna have to turn you into a pile of ashes.
Not so!
I knew he'd be okay!
I hope you had a nice nap.
Oh, yeah. Now I've got a fire in my belly.
The tumor went away.
Let's go!
Flames, eh? I'm fired up!
Hey, man! Mimic don't magic! Stealing my line!
Or no.
Would you stop tearing up our damn guild hall? What the? He disappeared.
Into the hole?
Can you not even smell him anywhere?
No, it's like he doesn't exist.
Here I am.
He could disappear into the shadows or something.
Damn it!
It's stealth magic. He can make himself completely invisible.
First master!
But it's a bit more than that, isn't it? I can also see things that are invisible. Your friendly ghost, for example.
Don't you dare touch her!
He's not going anywhere. He's just using a camouflage spell, which means he's still here! Loki!
Lion Radiance!
Now what?
I see you.
This guy might be a problem.
Loki!
That hurt. What'd you do?
Not good.
His weapon's invisible.
I hide and see all. I send away and snuff out. Those are the things my magic can do.
Stop! You're hurting me!
Lucy!
You blocked because you thought I was throwing something at you, right? I was actually cracking me whip behind me.
This level of power is what I'd expect from one of Zeref's 12 shields.
Or you can watch me punch you!
Not so!
If you want to know what hell's like, I'd be happy to show you firsthand. Now pay close attention to the young lady in front of you.
Okay. God damn
it. Like that. I made her clothes invisible.
It's like, okay.
Cut it out! Turn them back to normal!
How about making them invisible forever?
I'm closing your gate!
Now this is hell, don't you think?
Yeah, it is for me!
You've got a pretty weird concept of hell, buddy.
What do you mean by that, mate? There's a half-naked girl squirming in front of you. Don't you feel tormented? Embarrassed? I mean, do you look away? Or not look away?
Abby's like, nothing I haven't seen before.
I don't know, it's not like she wears that much anyway.
I wear clothes all the time, Natsu!
You're saying this doesn't bother you in the slightest?
I'm a little bit confused here. What's wrong with your face?
It's obvious.
I mean, he can't look.
I can't just look at you like that, can I? This technique is something like a double-edged sword because it puts me and my target both through an incredible amount of anguish and torture.
Not true.
Oh, Lucy, please don't take your underwear and stuff off, too. Oh, no, don't make us see your boobies.
No!
I think we should play along with them.
Yeah, guess you're right.
My God, what kind of sick people are you? You'd really...
Fairy tale.
Whoa, no, Lucy, no, you're butt no, naked! No.
Who cares? It's just skin. I'm not afraid to show off what I've got.
It's also indecent!
Holy crap, these are super soft!
Oh, yeah, don't stop, Natsu!
You're both so deprived and terribly lewd.
That's it.
Enough.
Sure.
I'll just get straight to the killing. Oh.
Regulus!
Fire Dragon!
Keep going. He's not done yet.
You brat. You've made this grown-up very angry.
I know what to do now.
Ah.
How we can take down Seraph.
Okay. She got the answer.
Guild Hall, we found a way to make the assassin lose his focus. But unfortunately, that unleashes the full force of his anger. Changing tactics, he decides to target all the fairy tale members trapped in his weird alternate dimension. Meanwhile, down in the south, Hargeon is thrust under a shadowy cloud as a new enemy enters the fray.
Next time, Historia of Corpses. All right.
A dark threat looms over the battlefield.
All right. Well, Mavis figured out how to beat Seraph, so that's one good news. Shelia lost her magic, defeating Dimaria. That's a bummer. And somehow Lucy always ends up naked. Classic fairy tale right there. And I'm not even joking. Really don't have much to take away from these episodes, so I don't have much else to say. This has been episodes 21 and 22. Like I said, my schedule is very odd, so I'm doing what I can. I might pre-record some more stuff, or I might do some stuff last minute. Who knows? I don't. I only have next week's schedule, or this, you know what I mean, this previous week's schedule at this moment, because this is only Wednesday the 11th. Anyway, this has been Orange Galen. Like, leave a comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification. I try to upload Fairy Tale every Sunday. Varies on time, usually around 10, but because of my work schedule, who knows? I'll upload on Sunday. It may be earlier, maybe later in the day. Once again, it'll just come out. And I will see you all later. I did it with the other hand. That was weird.
It's useless! Dark Red Lightning! What is this? Unable to analyze!
Megaton Red Lightning! Lightning that goes beyond lightning.
And this is to go even further beyond!
There are still forces coming from the east where we have no defense in place. And Seraph won't hold his position in the west forever. We could really use your tactical prowess right now, First Master.